chili paste, garlic and kimchi are a heady mix. Add to that fire beef and noodles. Welcome to the beautiful, delicious, surprising world of Korean food.
Join our food safari to learn the secret of tender bulgogi, a beginner's guide to kimchi, delicious rice and veggies, beautiful silky tofu, and a range of traditional rice cakes.
Korean food is really exciting food variety. Have to have rice and soup, always have to be, and kimchi. Those three things is most important for each meal. It's like it's really healthy food. It's got all the natural herbs and vegetables.
So it's the undiscovered health food of the world.
That's right.
Chung Jae Lee is chef at the acclaimed Mapo restaurant in Adelaide's food precinct of Guja Street. His traditional recipes with a modern twist have won loads of regular diners, as well as being named Best Asian Restaurant in Adelaide. He says his mother taught him many traditional recipes, and she still travels from Korea every year to help him create the best possible menus.
The sesame oil, the Korean one, it's got really, really good flavor. It's like a concentrate.
Mm.
So it smells is like a, everywhere. Once you're cooking with this one, you can smell from the maybe 3-4 meters away.
Really?
Yes. So, and then when you put in your mouth, it's not really oily, and I always use the Korean sesame oil.
And it's one of the key flavors in Korean food, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, without this one, anything is not good. And sesame seeds, okay? This has been low heat with a frying pan and cook it.
And what are toasted sesame seeds used for?
All of the Korean food. We're using everything this in there. All right, this is the japchae, which is a potato noodle. It's actually made from the potato, which is really good. We boil it with the water, and then we take it out, make a cold wash. You can put whatever seafood or beef, it's all it's up to you, but I prefer vegetarian dishes. This is the best one.
Yeah. And they cook too clear, don't they?
Yes, they become really nice and clear. And then it's actually, it's not really hard. It's not really soft in between. So it's good flavor.
It's got a little chewiness
yes,
to it though.
Yes, it is. Yeah. Not like a chewing gum, but.
Chili's used in many forms, isn't it?
Yeah, it does. It's any food in Korea without the chili, or people saying, oh, this is yuck.
Okay.
People love chili. They're addicted to chili. This is a chili paste.
So how is this used?
Okay, we're using a lot of things like a soup and some marinade, some pork.
And bibimbap, is this the paste
going? Bibimbap we're making with this one as well.
And is that a hot chili?
It's not really that hot, but the balsa chili is just once you eat, it's straight away, it's really burning.
Mm.
But these chilies come slowly. Nice, hot, coming and sweating slowly.
Oh!
Yeah, which is good chili.
Sounds
this one,
like a
like
very
it.
Pleasant experience.
Yeah, it does. Okay, this is the bean paste. It's a soybean paste. We're making doenjang soup. We're having all the time with the tofu, onion, and some cabbage, and things like that. We put it in all days, and still people eating this one anyway.
And is this what you put in with your bulgogi in the lettuce leaf?
Yes, you mix this one and this one as well.
Ah.
Mixed together.
Chung Jae, how important are vegetables in Korea?
Especially Chinese cabbage is the number one. Without this Chinese cabbage, we can't make kimchi.
Yeah.
So this is the number one vegetable we have to be pickled up. And the yellow bit is no good. It's always best bits inside. It's called nash pear, but in Korea, it's gonna call pear.
Pear.
Yes, pear. And this one I'm using more like a marinated food. That there is a natural acid come out and sweetness, I recommend this one.
Ah, and do you eat it just as a pear as well?
Yes, in Korea, we do it after lunch or dinner. We cut it off and nice slice, we eat it just like that. Nice. It's like our dessert. Okay, This garlic is without the Korean food, we can't make it, any other Korean food. This is really important, what we have to do. Per person, average Korean people eating, probably about 7 of this one, once a week, people eating one person.
That is very healthy.
Yes,
so
it is.
It's in what? Kimchi?
Soup, and some beef, and pork, and side dish. They're all garlic in there.
And do people have garlic breath? I mean, you don't notice.
Okay, yeah. Because everyone is eating garlic, so we don't know each other. And Korean culture, we don't kiss each other.
Don't you?
No, we don't.
Really?
We don't even hug. When we hug, we just tip like that.
Really?
Like that.
Ah.
Yeah.